Welcome to the second video of hashtag C++ series, and today we will talk about virtual constructors and destructors. Guessing the output of this code is a favorite question of many C++ interviewers. Honestly, I have been asked this question and I have also asked this question several times.
This is the code for which we have to tell the output. We are given two simple classes, base class and derived class. Both have public constructors and destructors with output statements in them. In the main function, the code that is given below is called, that is, a base class type pointer is used to make a derived class type object, which is deleted later. Now, we essentially have to understand what will be the order of constructors and destructors which will be called, which ones will be called, and thus what will be the final output. A hint that can be given for this question is that even if there was a virtual function in the base class which was called with no output statement, then the output of our code would still be the same.
Most of the people say that the output will be base constructor, derived destructor and base destructor. And they become really happy that they know the order in which constructors and destructors are called. But unfortunately, this is wrong answer. Note that the base class pointer was used to make the derived class object. So even if the functions in the base class are virtual, the destructor is not. So destructor has to be made virtual, otherwise the derived destructor is not called. According to the C++ philosophy, compiler for us will not make the destructor virtual even if there are virtual functions, because there is some price of making the destructor virtual. And C++ says that we are not going to make it for you even if you want it. So the compiler might throw a warning, but if you decide to ignore the warning, then it will lead to undefined behavior because the derived destructor is not called. So if you are asked to fix this code, all you have to do is make the base destructor as virtual.
As you can see in the code, the only change I have done is that I have made the base destructor as virtual. So since the base destructor is virtual, now derived destructor will also be called. And now the output will be base constructor, derived constructor, derived destructor, and base destructor.
So the lesson that we learned is, whenever dealing with runtime polymorphism, make sure that the base destructor is virtual. Once the interviewer has pointed this out, the next question can be, what about virtual constructors? Are they also necessary? To answer this, think about what we learned in the first video. Compiler makes the virtual pointer point to the V table in the constructor. So in the constructor, if virtual pointer is going to point, that means you cannot make the constructor as virtual, right? Because till then the object is not created, so there is no essentially function pointer that you can point to. The compiler should give you an error for trying to make constructor virtual. So now, if anyone tries to confuse you, remember that when dealing with runtime polymorphism, the base destructor should be virtual to avoid the undefined behavior. And there is nothing like virtual constructors. It is not possible because the V pointers are not yet pointing to the V table. So it doesn't make any sense. I hope the concept is clear. Let me know in the comments and don't forget to like, share and subscribe. It will mean a lot to me. Thank you.